Hi guys, welcome you all to my channel Explore Edu to Teach.
So the next topic that we'll be taking up is the stability analysis using Bode plot. So basically the video on Bode plot is already been uploaded on my YouTube channel. Please go and watch it out. In the control playlist you'll find the video. So the next topic, as I said, is the stability part. So we are going to deal with the terms like the gain crossover frequency, the phase crossover frequency, how to find out the gain margin, phase margin, and so on and so forth. So this is one of the most popular questions from this particular topic, to find out the gain margin as well as the phase margin. So the gain margin is been given as 1 upon g of j omega into h of j omega mod, where omega is equal to omega pc. So g of j omega, h of j omega is the open loop transfer function. Omega is equal to omega pc, where omega pc is the phase crossover frequency. If you have to find out the dB value of it, it is 20 log of gain margin. Similarly, the phase margin is equal to 180 degree plus angle of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to gc. I hope I am very clear with this. So always remember, the gain crossover frequency is given as omega gc. The phase crossover frequency is given as omega pc. The gain margin value is 1 upon mod of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to pc. And phase margin is equal to 180 degree plus angle of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to gc. I hope I am very clear with this. So let us deal with this first question and try to find out the different values. Okay. So the g of s is given as 10 upon 1 plus s into s plus 20. You can assume h of s as 1. So g of s into h of s, you can say as 10 upon 1 plus s into s plus 20. Find the gain margin and the phase margin. So the gain margin is equal to 1 upon g of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to pc, where omega pc value first you have to find out, right? So if I want to find out this gain margin value, where gain margin is equal to 1 upon g of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to pc, so you have to first find out the value of omega is equal to pc. Once you get that value, then you can substitute in mod of g omega, h of g omega term and find out the gain margin. So to find out the value of omega pc, always remember, you have to equate the angle of the complete equation to minus 180 degree. Understood? So to find out the gain margin, the formula says is 1 upon g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to pc. And to find out the omega pc value, you have to equate the open loop transfer function to minus 180 degree. So your minus 180 degree is equal to angle of the complete numerator and the denominator. So what is the numerator? Angle of 10 plus j0, that is angle of tan inverse of 0 by 10. Because always remember, x plus jy angle is given as tan inverse of y by x. So similarly, x stands here for 10. Y stands for 0. So it's tan inverse of 0 by 10 upon angle tan inverse of omega by 1 upon angle tan inverse of omega by 20. So tan inverse of 0 by 10 is tan inverse of 0, and tan inverse of 0 is 0, and tan inverse of omega into tan inverse of omega by 20 is given as this particular equation. For this, you can note down the formula that I am saying to you. You will also get the formula anywhere, but still I will tell you the formula used over here. Tan inverse of A into tan inverse of B is given as tan inverse of A plus B upon 1 minus AB. I hope I am very clear. I will repeat. Please note it down. Imagine tan inverse of omega as tan inverse of A, and tan inverse of omega by 20 is tan inverse of B. So tan inverse of A into tan inverse of B is given as tan inverse of A plus B upon 1 minus AB. So just put that equation over here. Find out the value of omega, and the omega value will turn out to be 0 or infinite. So you need to find out one value which is correct. Either it's 0, it can be either infinite. So what will I do is that I'll put the value of 0 and infinite over here. in this particular equation. So when I put the value of omega value as 0 in this particular equation, I will get my omega as z, my angle as 0. Now since my angle should be equal to minus 180 degree, that means omega is equal to 0 was not the right substitution. I hope I am very clear. Once I get the value of omega over here, I'll try to see which value of omega is correct. Is it 0 or infinite? So if it is 0, I will be directly substituting it in this equation and seeing whether the resultant value becomes equal to minus 180 degree or not. Here it is not minus 180 degree, hence omega is equal to 0 is not the right substitution. Now I put the value of omega is equal to infinite in this particular equation. If I put the value of omega is equal to infinite in this particular equation, I will get my angle as minus 180 degree, which is correctly given over here. And hence my omega is equal to infinite is a correct substitution for that. I hope I am very clear. And hence I get gain margin 1 upon g of g omega, h of g omega mod at omega is equal to pc. Omega is equal to pc, my omega is infinite, and try to find out the value. I hope I am very clear to you. Okay. The next thing is the phase margin. The phase margin is equal to 180 degree plus angle of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to gc. So how did you find out omega is equal to pc? By equating the angle of the equation to minus 180 degree. Similarly, to find out omega is equal to gc, substitute the magnitude value of mod of g omega, h of g omega equal to 1. Try to find out the answer. You will get the omega square value as minus 400 and minus 0.74. That means omega cannot have a defined value because the square of any particular number cannot be a negative number. Hence, since omega doesn't have a value, that means omega gc doesn't have a value. If omega gc doesn't have any value, that means phase margin is not defined. I hope I am very clear to you. So I'll just explain to you once more. So you will be given a particular open loop transfer function, and from this you will have to find out gain margin and phase margin. So for gain margin, you have 1 upon g of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to pc. And for phase margin, you have 180 plus angle of g omega into h of g omega at omega is equal to gc. So to find out the gain margin, you have to find omega pc. Omega pc ke liye, please equate the entire angle of this equation to minus 180 degree. Find out the answer. And you will get the value of your omega as 0 and infinite. Put this value onto the equation over here. And if you get it equal to minus 180 degree, it is fine. If you don't get it equal to minus 180 degree, that is, it is not the correct value. So in case of omega is equal to 0, equating over here, you will get a 0, and the 0 is not equal to minus 180 degree. But if I put omega value as infinite, I will get a minus 180 degree. That means omega value infinite is correct. Put that value over here as mod of 1 upon mod of g omega is equal to pc, and try to find out the gain margin. The phase margin is 180 degree plus angle of g omega, h of g omega at omega is equal to gc. Try to find out the value of omega. But the omega square value is basically a negative value. That means none of the values of omega gc is defined. Hence the entire term becomes undefined. I hope I am very clear to you. The next thing that we have is the classification of the system. That is a minimum, non-minimum and all-pass system. So the minimum phase is that particular system in which all the poles and zeros of the open loop transfer function are on the left hand side of the S-plane. Non-minimum, at least one pole or one zero can be on the right hand side of the S-plane. But in case of your all-pass system, the zeros and poles are identically symmetrical to each other and the magnitude is equal to 1. That means what? If I have a minimum system, the open loop transfer function will have all the zero and pole on the left hand side of the S-plane. The non-minimum system will have at least one zero pole on the right hand side of the S-plane, and the all-pass system will have zero and the pole which are exactly symmetrical. Okay, so in case of minimum and non-minimum phase, the magnitude is same, but the maximum system phase angle is more than the negative than the minimum phase system. So what does it mean? The minimum and the non-minimum will have magnitude as same, plus the maximum system phase angle is more negative as compared to the minimum phase system angle. So I hope am very clear to you? So please make a note of this particular thing. The notes are present in the description box. Please download it from there. The intermediate steps you will understand by referring the notes once. So please make a note of it. And I hope I am very clear with the concept. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you really like the video, please give a yes in the comment section and share it to as many people as possible. Encourage others also to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that even they get notified when the new video is going live. Many more videos are going to come in the future. So please do subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram. My channel is Explore Edu to Teach. Thank you so much. God bless you.